गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम रोहित गुप्ता, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सेंट एंड्रयूज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट। इन अप्लाइड साइंस डिपार्टमेंट आई एम टीचिंग यू प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स इन सेमेस्टर टू कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग। टूडेज टॉपिक रेंज, क्वार्टाइल रेंज एंड वेरियंस एंड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन। ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड mean, median and mode. Understood? Okay, now we will start range, quartile range and then the variance and standard deviation. Okay, now this one is called measure of dispersion. Understood? The range of a set of observation is defined as the difference between largest and smallest observation. What is range? Range is a set of observation which is defined as difference between largest and smallest observation. Range equals to maximum minus minimum. Range equals to greatest value minus smallest value. Understood? Now, interquartile range. It is given by Q3 minus Q1, where Q3, Q1 are the first and third quartile respectively of set of observation. Definitely, it's better than range since it makes use of 50% of data. Understood? Because Q3 or Q1 mein क्या करेंगे, पहले Q3 निकालेंगे, then Q1 निकालेंगे, first quartile and third quartile, 50-50% data use होता है, उसमें 2 points use होते हैं, understood? Okay, now variance and standard deviation. Variance is the sum of square of the deviation from mean. It's most important definition in your MDU examination. They ask what is variance and what is standard deviation. And the standard deviation is square root of variance. What is variance first? Variance is the sum of the square of the deviation from mean. Understood? Okay. Now it is denoted by sigma square. Understood? Variance is equals to sigma square. If x1, x2, x3, that is xm, are events from random variable x, then sigma square is equals to 1 upon n sigma xi. This is your summation. 1 upon n summation xi minus x bar ka whole square. Understood? What is x bar here? X bar is a mean of these events x1, x2, xn ka. Understood? Where x bar is mean, where f1, f2, f3, that is fn, is a frequency, and sigma square is equals to sigma. That means sigma square is equals to summation of fi xi minus x bar ka whole square. Understood? Fi xi minus x bar ka whole square upon capital N, and capital N is equals to summation of fi's. Sigma square is equals to, this is your variance, is equals to, this is for grouped data. If I am using frequency, sigma square is equals to summation of fi xi minus x bar ka whole square upon capital N. This is for grouped data, and this is for ungrouped data, means frequency at every event is 1. Understood? Where and sigma square is equals to summation of xi minus x bar ka whole square upon n. And this is a minus b. A minus b ka whole square, then we open this one to the a square plus b square minus 2ab, then a square, that is xi ka whole square plus x bar ka square minus 2xi x bar upon n. So summation of xi square plus x bar square minus 2xi x bar upon n, that is summation of xi square 2x bar 2 plus summation of x bar square minus x bar. I have taken common because x bar किसी भी डेटा का जो मीन होता है, that is a constant value. अरे अगर मेरे पास एक डेटा है, that is suppose that I am having 2, 4, 6, 8 like that. तो इसका जो मीन होगा 2 + 4 + 6 + 8/4, that is value will be 4. तो मीन always क्या होगा किसी भी डेटा का, that is constant. तो constant is always taken outside the integration, sorry outside the summation sign. So x bar is a constant, x bar square is also constant, then summation of xi square upon n plus x bar ka square, that is mean ka square, plus into summation of 1 minus 2 x bar into summation of xi upon n. Then x bar, where x bar is equals to summation of xi upon n. Understood? Now summation of xi square upon n plus summation of 1, if I 1 added n times. Understood?
if one added two times the value kitni hogi two, three times then three. तो अगर मैं one को n times add करूँगा तो value क्या होगी n. Then that means summation of xi square plus x bar square into n minus 2x bar into summation of xi की value क्या होगी n x bar. Understood है? Upon capital N, sorry M. So this implies xi square upon n plus x bar square minus 2n x bar square upon n. So n n cancel out. So x bar square minus x bar is 2x bar square. That is minus x bar square. So summation of xi square upon n minus x bar ka whole square. So sigma square. This is your variance. Variance is equals to sigma xi square upon n minus x bar ka whole square. Understood? This is called variance. So root, this one is variance. The standard deviation is equals to root of variance. If anybody asked me in your examination, in MDU examination, they ask define variance. Then you have to write that the difference between, this is your variance. Variance is the sum of the square of deviation from the mean. Means, what is the variance? Variance is sum of square of the deviation from the mean. And a standard deviation is square root of variance. Understood? Now, variance ka formula aap likh dena, sigma square is equals to 1 upon n. Sigma xi minus x bar ka whole square. This is for ungrouped data. This is for grouped data. Aap itna likh loge, aapke 2.5 marks clear ho jayenge. Understood? Then standard variance is equals to standard deviation equals to root of variance. Then variance is equals to standard deviation ka square. And standard deviation is equals to sigma. Understood? And variance is equals to sigma square. Sigma square is equals to 1 upon n sigma summation of xi minus x bar ka whole square. Understood? Sigma is equals to square root of 1 upon n summation of xi minus x bar ka whole square. This is called standard deviation. Note, thus, if lesser variance is more consistent or more uniform, agar kisi ka variance kam hai, that means sigma square ki value kam hai. Agar sigma square variance kam hai, that means that data is more consistent or more uniform. Are, suppose that uska mean data se fluctuates hoga little bit. तो डेटा क्या होगा मोर कंसिस्टेंट होगा. अंडरस्टूड है? ओके. आर यूनिफॉर्म होगा. वेरिएंस कैन नेवर बी नेगेटिव. अच्छा किस अगर ये स्क्वायर रूट है, वेरिएंस तो स्क्वायर से आता है ना. किसी भी नंबर का जब स्क्वायर करेंगे तो वो क्या आएगा, पॉजिटिव आएगा ऑलवेज. तो कभी भी नेगेटिव नहीं हो सकता. आइदर इज वैल्यू 0 आर पॉजिटिव. वेरिएंस ऑफ कांस्टेंट इज ऑलवेज 0. अच्छा जस्ट अ थिंग, अभी हम प्रूफ करेंगे इसको. सम ऑफ डिफरेंस फ्रॉम मीन इज ऑलवेज 0. Understood? Variance constant क्या होता है? Zero. Difference from mean क्या होता है? Zero. Sum का क्या था? Variance are equal for different group. Greater mean is more consistent. If variance are equal, तब हम कैसे चेक करेंगे कि डेटा कंसिस्टेंट है या कम मोर कंसिस्टेंट है या लेस कंसिस्टेंट है. तब क्या चेक करेंगे हम? मीन चेक करेंगे. Understood? Okay. Now suppose that पहली थिंग क्या है, सेकंड वाला प्रूफ करिए. वेरिएंस ऑफ कांस्टेंट इज 0. इफ आई एम टेकिंग द कांस्टेंट का वेरिएंस लेना, अगर मैं तो इवेंट कैसे होंगे, कांस्टेंट होंगे. अरे वेरिएंस ऑफ x तो सिग्मा xi माइनस x बार का होल स्क्वायर अपॉन n होता है. अच्छा मैंने अगर कांस्टेंट लिया तो सारे इवेंट्स क्या होंगे, कांस्टेंट. सपोज दैट इवेंट्स ले लो a a a मींस x1 की वैल्यू a, x2 की वैल्यू a, x3 की वैल्यू a, x5 4 की वैल्यू a, x5 की वैल्यू a, कहां तक जाएगा xn. सारी वैल्यूज ए है, मींस एक्स ए इज कांस्टेंट. अच्छा आप बताओ अगर ये कांस्टेंट है तो मैं इसका मीन क्या आएगा, मीन समेशन ऑफ ए एन टाइम्स, तो एन ए अपॉन एन, तो एन एन कैंसिल, तो क्या आएगा ए, यानी कि मीन क्या होगा ए. अच्छा बताओ एक्स वन से जब एक्स आई माइनस ए करेंगे तो ए माइनस ए कितना हो गया, जीरो, और सब में जीरो जीरो आएगा, और स्क्वायर करेंगे तो क्या होगा, जीरो, और एड करेंगे तो क्या होगा, जीरो. मीन्स वेरियंस ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट कितना हुआ, जीरो. Understood है? अगर नहीं समझ में आया एक बार करके देखना. कैसे, सारे सबको क्या लेना, सारे इवेंट्स ए ले लेना, तो उसका मेन भी ए आ जाएगा और वेरिएंस भी उसका जीरो आ जाएगा. Understood है? sum of differences from mean is always zero. Just look at this and prove that sum of difference from mean, that is xi minus x bar, is equal to zero. This is your LHS. This is summation of xi minus x bar. Taken summation inside this one, inside the bracket, and summation of xi minus summation of x bar upon capital small n. So summation of xi upon n minus x bar sigma 1. Understood? Understood? Okay. Now, तो अगर मैं 1 को n times add करूंगा तो 1 1 sorry n n cancel हो जाएगा, तो n n cancel हो तो sigma xi upon n minus x bar. We know that that is sigma xi upon n equals to x bar. Now put the value. So x bar minus x bar, that is equal to 0. Then LHS equals to RHS. Now find mean and standard deviation from the following data. If you are having a data, means this type of data you are having, then find mean and standard deviation of this data. This data have class interval and frequency. Class interval 0 to 5, then frequency 3, 5 to 10, then frequency 7, 10 to 15, 11, 15 to 20, 8, 20 to 25, 2. तो corresponding हम क्या लेंगे, उसका solution निकालेंगे. तो class interval अगर 0 to 5 है, तो मुझे इसका क्या करना है, mean and variance निकालना. अच्छा mean का formula क्या होता है, so frequency भी है, तो class interval से पहले हम क्या निकालेंगे, x निकालेंगे. अच्छा class interval से x निकालेंगे, that is upper limit plus lower limit by 2, तो 0 plus 5 by 2, that is 2.5. 5 plus 10 by 2, that is 7.5. 15 plus 10 by 5, 2, that is 12.5. 15 plus 20 by 2, that is 17.5. 20 plus 25 by 2, 22.5. Understood? This is your value of x. Okay? Understood? Now you are having f. So f ki value kya? 3, 7, 11, 8, 2. Understood? Now, agar aapko mean nikalna hai, to formula kya hota hai? Xi fi upon capital N. And capital N is equals to sigma fi. Understood? Now, put the value. Agar xi is equals to, sigma xi is equals to kya aega? 62.5. This is your 62.5, 22.5 plus 17.5. That is 40 plus 22.5, 62.5. Understood? Okay, now, this is summation of xi. I want to find sigma fi xi upon n, and capital N is equal to sigma fi. So sigma fi kitna hoga? 3 plus 7, 10, 11, 21, 8, 29, 2, 31. 31 hai? So fi xi, so fi sigma fi xi ka summation nikal lena. Aur aap isko kar loge, to 382.5 upon 31 aa jayega. Okay, now you want to find variance. Achha, variance ka formula kya hota? That is 1 upon sigma xi square, sorry, 1 upon n fi xi minus x bar ka whole square. 1 upon n f sigma, sorry, summation fi xi minus x bar ka whole square. Agar mujhe xi minus x bar ka whole square chahiye summation mein, to main kya pehle find karunga? Xi minus x bar. Aur x bar kitna mila? 382.5 by 31. Aap isko solve kar lena. Jab xi minus x bar se karoge, tab aapki value aayegi minus 9.85. तो आपका ये आ जाएगा 12.35 समथिंग. अंडरस्टूड है? ओके. और माइनस 4.83 आएगा, 0.17 आएगा. ट्वेल्व पॉइंट थ्री थ्री आएगा. एक्स आई माइनस एक्स बार 5.17 आएगा, 10.17 आएगा. अंडरस्टूड है? नाउ xi माइनस x बार का स्क्वायर करोगे, तो 9.85 का स्क्वायर 96.62, 4.83 का स्क्वायर 23.32, 0.17 का स्क्वायर 0.0289, 5.17 का 26.72, 10.17 का 103.72. देन fi xi माइनस x बार का होल स्क्वायर, मींस fi इज दिस वन एंड मल्टीप्लाइड बाय दिस xi माइनस x बार का होल स्क्वायर एंड समेशन ऑफ ऑल, then divided by summation of x, then calculate, you do it yourself. Okay, it's so simple. Aapko sirf apply karna hai formula, that is summation of xi minus x bar ka whole square, sorry, summation of fi xi minus x bar ka whole square upon capital M. करेक्ट. ओके नेक्स्ट वन कॉफिशियंट ऑफ वेरिएशन. अंडरस्टूड. व्हाट इज द कॉफिशियंट ऑफ वेरिएशन? कॉफिशियंट ऑफ वेरिएशन इज अ रेशियो ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन टू द मीन एक्स बार ऑफ डेटा सेट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 100. व्हाट इज कॉफिशियंट ऑफ वेरिएशन? दिस इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट. अंडरस्टूड. In your examination, they ask what is mean, means आपको पूछ सकते हैं that is what is variance, what is standard deviation, what is coefficient of variance. एक question इस type का आता है sir. Understood? Okay. It's so simple. Okay. Now coefficient of variation is a ratio of standard deviation to the mean of data set multiplied by 100. It is measure of relative variability. And it's a dimensionless. Sometimes in your computational examination, what is the dimension of coefficient of variation? They ask. The coefficient of variation is a dimensionless value. Understood? Okay. Then CV coefficient of variation is equals to sigma upon x bar, that is the standard deviation upon mean into 100. So sigma upon x bar is called coefficient of dispersion. Sometimes in your examination, what they ask, what is coefficient of dispersion also? The coefficient of variance mein 100 ka multiple nahi kar, means 100 ka divide de denge, ya to sigma upon x bar ko coefficient of dispersion kate hai. Okay. Now, lesser sigma implies lesser coefficient of variation. If sigma ki value 5 hai, to coefficient of variation kam hoga. If sigma ki value 100 hai, so obviously its coefficient of variation jyada hoga. That means it is because its coefficient of variation is directly proportional to standard deviation. So when standard deviation increases, then coefficient of variation is also increased. Simple hai. Okay, now find mean and variance of first and natural number. In previous year or previous to previous year, they asked this type of question, means first mean and variance of first and natural number. This question asked by two methods. This question asked in first unit also, that is if x is a random variable. I will discuss that. I think I have discussed in class also if x is a discrete random variable and x is a natural number. Understood? Then the find mean and variance of this first and natural numbers. This type of question asked in unit 1 also. Okay, first we will discuss if n is a natural number. Simply, if n is a natural number means aapko mean or median x variance nikala. Acha, n natural numbers, so natural numbers hote kaise? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is n types. Then x bar is equals to summation of n, because nth term kya hai? N aap ya to isse summation of I bhi likh sakte ho. upon n, because we know that आपको पता है ना कि जब sigma n की value क्या होती है, sigma n की value होती है n plus 1 by 2. Sigma n is equals to nn plus 1 by 2. Sorry, beech mein, there is a technical problem. So, sigma n is equals to nn plus 1 by 2 upon n. Then nn cancel out. Then sigma, that is x bar is equals to n plus 1 by 2. Understood? Okay. Your x bar, that is mean. Mean of n natural numbers is n plus 1 by 2. Now, variance of first n natural number. What is the variance? Formula of variance is equals to sigma square is equals to summation of xi minus x bar ka whole square. Okay. In variance ka formula maine jab open kiya tha, then its formula sigma xi ka whole square upon n minus x bar ka whole square. Understood? Now, if I to nth term kya iska? Ith term n hai. So sigma n square upon n minus mean kya hai? X bar ki value kya hai? N plus 1 by 2 ka whole square. Then sigma n square ki value kya hoti hai? Means summation of first n natural numbers ka kya hota hai? Summation of square of first n natural numbers. To hota hai n plus 1 by 2 n plus 1 by 6 upon n simply minus n plus 1 का whole square upon 4 when we simplifying this one then n plus 1 by 2 taken common अरे ये n plus 1 है यहाँ पे भी n plus 1 है तो 2 भी common आ जाएगा तो n plus 1 by 2 taken common then in bracket remaining 2n plus 1 understood n and upon 3n the n cancel out 2n plus 1 by 3 minus n plus 1 by 2 now and so then take the LCM 2 of 2 and 3 का that is 6 so then multiply 2 here and multiply 3 here the 2 का multiple 2n plus 1 में 3 का multiple n plus 1 में so that is 4n plus 2 minus 3n minus 3 upon 6 then this is this value will be 4n minus 3 and that is n 2 minus 3 that is minus 1 so n plus 1 by 2 into n minus 1 by 6 then value will be n square minus 1 by 12 this is your variance if I'm talking about standard deviation so what is standard deviation standard deviation is denoted by sigma and sigma is equals to square root of variance then standard deviation sigma is equals to root of n square minus 1 by 12 this is most important in your examination they ask find mean and variance of first n natural numbers and using this find mean and variance of first 10 natural suppose that first 10 natural numbers to aap batao variance kya hoga first 10 natural numbers n ki value 10 put kar doge 10 ka square that is 100 minus 1 upon 12 that is 99 upon 12 that value will be 11 by 4 understood or root mein kya aayega 11 by 4 to root 11 by 2 this is your standard deviation and some mean kya ho jayega that is n plus 1 by 2 that means अगर आपको 10 नंबर्स को चाहिए तो 10 प्लस 1 11 बाय 2 दैट इज 5.5 ओके नाउ टुडे वी हैव डिस्कस थ्री थिंग्स फर्स्ट वन इज रेंज अनदर वन इज क्वार्टाइल रेंज रेंज इज यूजिंग ओनली टू डेटा ग्रेटेस्ट वैल्यू आर मैक्सिमम वैल्यू माइनस मिनिमम वैल्यू बट इंटर क्वार्टाइल रेंज यूजेस 50% ऑफ डेटा एंड वैल्यू विल बी Q3 माइनस Q1 एंड Q1 एंड Q3 इज कॉल्ड फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड quartile respectively understood they are this is definitely better than range because it's using 50% of data understood okay now most important thing is variance is just variance ki definition then you put the this formula this is for grouped data and this is for ungrouped data where capital N is equal to summation of fi understood okay where standard deviation is equals to square root of variance एंड वेरियंस का फॉर्मूला क्या होगा अगर ब्रेक करके रख दे ब्रैकेट को ब्रेक कर दे तो सिग्मा स्क्वायर इज इक्वल्स टू समेशन ऑफ एक्स आई स्क्वायर अपॉन स्मॉल एन माइनस एक्स बार का होल स्क्वायर अगर ग्रुप डेटा का होता तो सिग्मा स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू समेशन ऑफ एफ आई एक्स आई बार का होल स्क्वायर सॉरी समेशन ऑफ एफ आई एक्स आई का स्क्वायर अपॉन कैपिटल एन माइनस मीन का स्क्वायर अंडरस्टूड ओके नाउ प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ वेरियंस ओके नाउ This is your example. Then please ये question आप solve कर लेना. Solve this question. This is important. Coefficient of variance is also important. And last one is find mean and variance of first n natural numbers. Mean of first n natural number that is n plus 1 by 2 and variance of first n natural number n square minus 1 by 12. Okay. Now. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.